So I suppose the one area that kind of resonates a lot with me is the stigma associated with depression. I suppose before my own experience, I had an interpretation of in my own life of what it was, which was completely alien to what I had suffered. But it was based on what I'd seen through media or heard through friends or heard through family. And to be honest, I'm probably a bit ashamed of the way I used to think about people who suffered from a mental illness before my own experience. It wasn't nice, and I can understand why society would stigmatize people. For me, the stigma associated with mental health is kind of two-pronged as such. It's this historical thing, you know, these mental health asylums, everyone locked up and chained up and being treated with all these different weird electric shocks and all this kind of stuff. And, you know, that kind of embedded our impression of what mental illness was. The second one, that if you had a mental illness, you were locked away. But the day-to-day stigma has actually surprised me. And it surprised me to the fact that in a society that's more open, that's more interconnected, that we still have this inability to talk openly about mental health, both positive and negative. This affects everybody at some stage in their life. This is what the World Health Organization is telling us. And a lot of the stigma sometimes comes from people who suffer themselves, because they don't want people to know they've suffered. So they can be the worst type, because they won't speak about it, and they'll speak down about maybe other people to hide their own insecurities. If I was really going to be true to myself, then I had to be true to everyone else as well, and talk openly. And I think that's still there among a lot of organizations and companies. There's a stigma around people with mental health conditions, and, you know, we need to be careful. Watch Johnny there. He, you know, he's a couple of dark days. Don't leave him near any of those buttons. And that's not the reality for someone that's suffering, you know. We need to be in a society where we can actually understand what someone is going through. How the community view you as an individual is very important. You know, being involved in GA clubs, soccer clubs, rugby clubs, it should be okay to say, do you know what, I'm having a bad time at the moment, I'm having a bad day. And people leave it at that and support you if they want, but not fit you in this jar and put you on a shelf that, you know, listen, yeah, hi, Steve, you know, Grant, he's the fellow there, no, that I was telling you about. You know, we need to break away from that if we're to have a society that's going to accept people rather than reject them for what's going on. If someone broke their arm in the morning or broke their leg and was on crutches, you know, you'd be over, come here, geez, what happened, Jay? You all right? Oh, geez, you're very unlucky, you know. Listen, if you need to lift their hand or anything, give me a shout. Whereas when someone's going through a mental illness, it's an internal thing. You don't see a cast. You don't see crutches. And if someone even alludes to it, oh, okay, look, you'll be grand tomorrow and walk away. We have a completely different approach, but both are the same. Both are a medical condition and both need the same type of support. So stigma is alive and well in Ireland and in the world, but we are in a better place than what we were a number of years ago. But there's still an awful lot to do. And we as individuals have our own part to play in that. There's still a lot of stigma associated with depression and mental illness. So it's hard to gain any traction. So that's why it's important to actually talk about it.